So I do have PowerToys installed. I have the 0.18 release on my machine. One of the coolest features is I can do this alt space and voila, I can start typing. So I don't know if you come from the Mac world, this is Spotlight, and this made me so productive as an actual developer on Mac, was being able to quickly get to a list of things very quickly. And I think I showed this one the other day. I was looking for a document. I do store a few of my documents here. You could do the asterisk dot docx. And so, yeah, it shows my trip report that I had before. Also over here, this is some of the JSON values that I currently have. But what's kind of interesting is if I go visual and then space, I have the option here. Obviously, I've got everything installed, like code and like 2019 and a few probably betas or something. You can quickly launch any of those applications. Over here is this little command. Let's zoom on in. Little command right here, which is run as the administrator. Or if you wanted to, you can come right over here and you can open it in a new folder. I don't know, those little things like that. And I'm so used to when I want to get like an elevated command prompt. How do you typically go about your elevated command prompt, Gregor?
I kind of cheat. If you hold shift down and then right click on the shortcut.
Shift, and then I'm going to right click on this icon right here, right?
Try it on Visual Studio.
Yay! Run as administrator. You can do it that way. You can also create just a little icon here that would take you straight to that. Basically pass the parameters for the command prompt to be in administrator mode. Or sometimes people, they may go like PowerShell and then they may click on this right here. I guess the whole point is that it's just a lot easier to kind of get what you need, you know, like right here, PowerShell. Well, it's one down. So it'd be interesting on how they make the actual connection. So yeah, this would be the PowerShell that I'd probably want, or here, and then I would go to the administrator button. But you could do, I think there was more stuff that was inside of this. So alt space, and then you could do these things. I don't know. It's like simple things that is very good to have. So I know this is the feature you were looking for. Was being able to do math.
I didn't know you could do that.
Yeah, being able to do some math inside of this little prompt instead of going to like calculator. And then you can run, let's try winget. Also, I've tried this one right here, but you know what? I don't think I got this to work. And I believe the reason for this was that it automatically closes that little thing in the background. So it runs a command and then it moves off and does something else. Okay, so inside though of PowerShell, let's go, yes, I just clicked the wrong thing. Those two icons look a little bit of a lock, at least to me. This is the PowerShell. And here's how I've got mine kind of set up. I've got it for always run as administrator. I've got run on startup and then I'm using the dark. You can obviously pick whatever you want there. So dark theme, the first one was the fancy zone. So this is brand new. This is brand new to 18. And so I've set up mine as these two columns. So I don't know if everybody caught that a little bit earlier, but you can change this to multiple panels. So here I'm at three panels. You can see in the background, it's kind of cleaning those up. You can go into this focus mode where you'll have two applications running. Here we can add like a third screen or fourth screen or even more. And then there's also the ability to use custom. I haven't created a custom one before, but I know you can do this edit on the layouts and then you can move some of this around to be just like you want it to be. One of the things that I was using was over here. I love this feature, show space around zones. So like space around zones is 20. So if you are able to see, let's take this one and let's see if this will work right off the bat for us today. still thinking. Wow, that one is doing that. It only has a problem. Only if it is this terminal application. So there's that one. And then going back over to our web browser. And there's the 20% spacing around there. I just think it looks so much nicer and cleaner with that. Have you used this?
Yeah, I've got a 49-inch monitor, so I've got kind of three columns split. So I've kind of got like email on the left, I've kind of got Visual Studio on the right, and whatever else on the right, Google, for example. So I use that every day. I didn't actually know about the alt space thing. Believe it or not, I'd never tried the search thing. That's very, very cool. That's called PowerToys Run, in case anybody's interested. I've just been looking at that.
Yeah. And yes, I can draw. I installed a ZoomInt, which has been around for like ever.
So let me give you a little ZoomInt tip. Yeah. Bring up ZoomInt and then try using Shift and drawing. So you can draw lines and shapes and all that. And if you do Control Shift, you can do an arrow. If you press G for green, you'll get green colors, and blue for B for blue. And you can do all sorts of stuff.
Yes. And that's all of those. All of those commands are inside of the, if you run the tool, I thought it shows up down here in this little tray. I'm looking down here. It does not show it down here at the moment.
Yeah, I don't like
it. But there is so that package, by the way, I only just used kind of like the beginner stuff for ZoomInt. But if you want to know how to do some of the zooming in and some of this other stuff, right here, begin control one, zoom in, zoom out. You can change the pen color. This is what you were referring to, right? Was like the pen color to like a red, blue, yellow meeting timer. Have you ever used that feature?
The meeting timer? No, I have not. No.
Me either.
I didn't even know it was what they are.
So we just finished up talking a little bit about ZoomInt. You know, we're talking about the latest and greatest innovation in build. And I've got ZoomInt on the screen, which is probably like 20 years old now. Where are we going to be heading?